Okay, today we're going to talk about the differences between male and female skulls. And you would think that it would be a much more obvious thing to look elsewhere in the body, specifically the pelvis, which we will be talking about later. But for today, we're going to talk about the differences in the skull itself. And so there's only a few features I'm going to have you learn, and I'm going to go over those right now. So the first thing is that the male skull, once he loses the top of his cranium, the male skull has a more U-shaped jaw or mandible. So when you look here, it's going to look a little bit broad and flat at the bottom, where a female has a more V-shaped and gives what we call a more gracile, excuse me, or delicate feature. So the first one is the mandible being U-shaped for a male and V-shaped for a female. Now, when we talk about some of the other features, we need to look specifically at the eye orbits. And the eye orbits are actually the socket where the eyeball sits. And there's two features on the eye that I want to point out to you today. The first is, and we've already seen that this is a male skull, it has a more square eye orbit. So when you look, you're going to see a more squarish appearance. Now, they're not going to be perfect squares the way you think of a perfect square in math is. But what we are talking about is more square features compared to a more rounded eye orbit. Unfortunately, I don't have a female skull I can show you with, but we'll take a look at some drawings, some line drawings of female skulls when we are finished with the video today so you can compare to what you see. So a square eye orbit. The other part of this that's interesting is when you look at the upper edge, or what we call the superior margin of the eye orbit, we have a more blunt edge. In other words, it almost seems like it's a little bit flattened out, like if it were clay, you'd taken your finger and rubbed it across to kind of flatten it out, where a female margin to an eye orbit is going to be more sharply defined. It'll be thinner, as if you pinched the clay there. So flattened for the male. All right, so we have three features we've learned so far. We have the square or U-shaped chin. We have the square eye orbits, okay, so two squares. And then we have a more blunt margin on the upper eye orbit. Those are the first three. Now I'm only going to give you two more, and I'm going to switch skulls for just a minute for one of them. On this skull, it's a little more easy to see. We've learned the bones in the skull, and so I want to talk specifically about the zygomatic arch. Now, we know what the zygomatic arch is. It's this arch right here that actually is open on the backside. So it's this arch that extends backwards. If the zygomatic arch stops just before the external auditory meatus, in other words, the hole for your ear, so if this arch stops before the external auditory meatus, then this is a male skull. And you can see quite clearly that this one ends just in front, just before the external auditory meatus. Okay, so we've got this arch that ends. If this were a female, this arch would extend back past that opening, and you would have a line that goes a little bit further back. Okay, so you would look for that. So now we have four features: the square mandible on the male, the square eye orbits, the blunt superior margin, and we have the ending of this zygomatic arch with no extension or ridge going past the external auditory meatus. Now, while I have you here looking at the side view of this skull, this is the last feature, or next two more features we have. One is, this is the mandible, as we know. And this particular part of the mandible is called the ramus, R-A-M-U-S. And in the ramus, if it extends and is more vertical, so that this forms a more right angle here, then this is a male skull. If this were a little more slanted this way, it kind of kicked back just a little bit, and this would be a female skull. So we have a number of features we can look at yet again real quickly. We have the square jaw for the male, the square eye orbits, the blunt superior margin. We have the ending of the zygomatic arch, and then we have the more vertical, less angled ramus on the mandible. And the last one is the nuchal crest. And when we first learned the bones in the skull, we learned that the nuchal crest is on the, and you should have all said, occipital. Okay, so we're going to turn to the back of the skull. And this one, it's a little harder to see on. So I'm going to put this guy to one side, and we'll go back to this other skull. And this one is very, very pronounced. In this particular one, what we see is a rough and bumpy nuchal crest at the back of the occipital bone. Okay, so we're talking about inferior to this bulge here, and it is rough and very bumpy. If it's rough and very bumpy at the nuchal crest, then we have a male skull. So we have several features on this skull alone that show us it's a male. You could have variations. If you were to compare 15 male skulls, some would not have as much pronounced roughness in the nuchal crest, but they could have a very pronounced right angle to the ramus and some very square eye orbits. So what you do is you don't say, well, it has to have all seven perfectly, but what you say is, I've got 5 out of 7 that line up really pretty nicely, and then the other two, not quite as perfectly, but I'm still saying the preponderance or the majority of the evidence says that this is a male, and these are the facts that I'm looking at that tell me it's a male. So when you do your skeleton identification and you determine whether the skeleton on the test is male or female, you're going to have to give me specific features like I've just given you on how to tell a male from a female and which ones support your conclusion. Is it a male? Is it a female? And what are they? Is it a square jaw? Is it a V-shaped jaw? Is it rounded eye orbits or square ones? If it's square, then it's a male, and so on. So you'll have to do the defense yourself. So those are the features we're talking about today. We've got the rough nuchal crest. We've got the vertical ramus. We've got the zygomatic arch ending in front of the external auditory meatus. We've got the square eye orbits. We've got the blunt edge to the superior margin of the orbit. And then we have the U-shape or square jaw. Okay? So those are your features. Make sure that you go over them. Make sure that you study them, because those will be your support materials for part of your identification on your test. Thank you.